okay.
Okay, he's doing okay, but he's stuck on a particular question. Now, there are still four possible answers. One of these is the right answer. Okay.
Okay.
Next voice you hear will be Dougie's. He'll tell you the question. There are four possible answers. One of these is the right answer. Okay, Dougie, lots of luck. Your time starts now.
John, Andreas Vesalius was a pioneer in which field of science? Anatomy, space exploration, volcanology, or astronomy? That's Andreas Vesalius, V-E-S-A-L-I-U-S. 10 seconds, John.
I'm not sure, Dougie. It may be anatomy, but I'm not sure.
That's kind of what I thought, but yeah, not very sure either. Absolutely.
All right.
Thanks, mate. Cheers. Yeah. I think it's time to ask the audience, Chris.
Audience, this is worth £500,000. So no pressure. All on your keypads, please. Let's see if we can get Dougie up to £500,000. This is the question. Andreas Vesalius was a pioneer in which field of science? It's worth £500,000. A, B, C, or D. All vote now. Oh.
Yeah, interesting.
Yeah, interesting's a good word, Doug.
Yeah, good.
Terrifying's another.
Terrifying is another.
There's nothing on my screen. You've
yeah.
got 61% of this audience thinks anatomy.
Yes.
4%
yes, yes.
space exploration. 18 volcanology. 17 astronomy.
Vesalius. If it is anatomy, and my dad was still alive, he was a doctor. And he would be sitting at home screaming at the TV. I think I'm going to take the money. I think that's...
It's your call. Take your time, have a look.
I think it's the only sensible thing to do, because if I lost it, I would just kick myself, you know?
Is that your final answer, Dougie? Ah. Apparently not. There's no time limit on Millionaire. Take as long. It's a huge amount of money.
It is a huge amount of money.
You are two questions away from £1,000,000. You're probably the closest you've ever been in your life to £1,000,000,
certainly.
But it's your call. You can walk away anytime you want. It's worth £500,000.
Yeah, it's just too big a gamble, Chris. I think, yeah, final answer. Could I take money, please?
Sure. Yeah. Give him a big hand. Dougie Wilson goes away with £250,000. Well played. I can tell you, if you want to know this, 61% of this audience said anatomy. You thought it was anatomy when it first came up. Your mate John said, not sure, probably anatomy of the four possibilities. If you said to me anatomy, mm-hmm. I'd be tearing this cheque up for £250,000. I would be writing you out another cheque for £500,000.
There we go.
There we go. It was the right answer. Hey, I think you did the right thing. Give me the big hand. £250,000 to Dougie Wilson. Well played, Doug. Good man. God bless you. Thanks a lot.
The end.
Now, you've got the time it takes for the ads to finish to guess what Bully's star prize will be. It's Bullseye, next on Challenge.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Join two Ukrainian football legends as they captain an all-star lineup at Stamford Bridge.
Join us. Play your part to support Ukraine.
We'll be right back.
galaxy still needs its guardians.
You're an idiot.
I am Groot.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. Available now in Sky Store.
There's only one place to experience every magical moment.
Wicked.
Sky Cinema Wizarding World. Available now.
I'm getting some static from polyester blouses, and I can smell the hairspray from here. It must be time to play Bullseye on Challenge.
Congratulations, number three. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Crowd. We've got a marvellous crowd in tonight. One that from all the four corners of the Labour Exchange, all over England, we've got this audience in from tonight. Nice to have you with us on this Sunday evening. Have you had a good tea? All right, was it? Are you keeping warm? We'll help to keep you warm these cold nights. Welcome the first couple tonight who are going to play with us on Bullseye from Central Television Area, Paul Moss and Mal Thornton. Malcolm, nice to be with us. From Central, you're from King's Heath in Birmingham.
King's Heath.
So you haven't travelled too far, have you?
From there. No.
To get down to us at the studios, that's very good. Now, tell us you're a painter and decorator, is that right?
That's true.
Oh, I don't want you stirring it up in here. Give it now. See? Stirring it up with a... Now, when did you start being a painter and decorator? Tell us.
When I was first left school, when I was 15 years
really?
Old.
Really? So when you were in your prime? Well, the good lines these, aren't they, Paul? Nice to have you with us, Paul. Now then, Malcolm. Now tell us, you're the academic of the team, is that right, Mal?
Well, that's what I'd like to think, yeah.
I'll translate this. That's what he likes to think. That's what he said. You want to get like to think? That's like to think. Go on, talk to us, Malcolm. What do you do for a living?
I'm a lecturer in computer studies at the moment. Really?
This is a lecture at college, or is this...
it's a private company, and we train mainly government training schemes for students.
Really? And you haven't got a degree in computing, you've just learnt computing as it's gone along?
Yes.
Fine. Well, that's wonderful. But before that, what did you do before you became a computer
expert?
Well,
I used to be a teacher when I first started.
What subject did you teach?
PE.
Did you really? Well, now, before I became a comic, I used to teach PE. Yeah, and what did you do? I did, seriously. What did you do before... You don't believe me, sir. It's because I look knackered. What did you do before you were a teacher, Mal?
Well, I was a surf accountant manager as well.
Really?
Yeah, so you could say I went from, marking the books to making the books.
It's very good. So another PE teacher wants to be a comic. You see? All the time. Nice to have you with us, Mal. Go and get yourselves nice and settled, Mal, and over there, Paul. Thank you very much. Welcome the next couple tonight playing Bullseye. They're all the way from Television South, Gary Mansfield and Philip Pound. Make them nice and welcome. Nice to have you with us. And you're from whereabouts are you from?
Horsham in Sussex.
Horsham in Sussex. It's very posh down there in Sussex, isn't it? Speak very well, don't they, down there? Not like them other two scruffy lads. Yeah, we're all to come from around here, law. Lovely accents, marvellous accents. What do you do, Gary? Tell us what you do for a living.
I'm a clerical assistant with British Telecom.
British Telecom? Well, your name rang a bell. It's, I don't feel embarrassed doing these lines, you know. Philip, what do you do, sir, for a living?
I'm an insurance underwriter.
An underwriter?
Yeah.
Now, I always thought an underwriter was the fella who put the Y on the front of Y front. Now, listen, tell us, you're into languages, aren't you?
Yes,
Are you involved with this in your job?
Yes, I work with overseas insurance.
Really?
Yeah.
Selling English insurance abroad?
Not selling it, no. Generally providing head office backing to agents and subsidiary companies abroad.
Well, isn't that exciting?
It's a job.
It's a job. And they pay you well for it, do they?
Well,
you could, no, you better not say. You might. His is in ruins. Yours might be as well. We'd like you to go and settle down, relax for the game. It's a privilege to have you on the show, both of you. Off you go, Gary. Thank you, Philip. Excellent. And the next couple tonight playing Bullseye, they're from Television Southwest, right down there in the Cornwall area. Terry and Pauline Tookie. Make them nice and welcome. Hey, Terry. Hello, Pauline. How are you? Wasn't that nice when you came on holding hands? Did you see that when they came on holding hands? Ah.
I'd have fallen over.
Ah. You can tell they haven't been married long. What do you do for a living, Pauline?
Student psychiatric nurse.
Student psychiatric nurse? Mm-hmm. Well, how far through your training are you?
I've done 12 months and just taken finals and waiting for results.
And you're waiting for your results? So that's exciting, isn't it? Well, we hope you do well with it. What's your hobby?
Walking.
You like walking? Mm. Yeah. Does he like walking?
Yes, but not the same variety as I do.
What sort of walking do you like?
The nice level sort, and that country paths and all that.
Yeah, but what's Terry's sort of walking?
Mountains.
Is it?
My main love is North Wales, round...
Over the peaks, yeah. Do you go on your own?
No, I take my dog, Heidi, with me.
Oh, you take your dog?
Yeah, she's a collie.
Yeah, I've never known a fella cross a peak with a collie. Oh, it gets worse, doesn't it? Have a good night with us. I know you've had a nice day. We hope you enjoy it tonight. Off you go, Polly and Terry. Thank you very much. Excellent. All right. Well done. You're a lovely audience. We hope you're enjoying it at home as much as we are here, because I'm in a smashing time tonight. All right, we've met the contestants. Let's get on with the game. Now, you know now about Bully's Board with the categories where the dart player tries to win questions for his partner, and I'm the lad for the job because I've got the questions right here. OK, now, we arranged the order of players, you know by now, before we came on the air tonight, and all the contestants are sitting there ready to play the game. So, Mal, although it's your question, Philip and Pauline, hands on your bonus buttons, because if Mal gets it wrong, you have a chance to earn some money. Mal, choose a subject for Paul.
Sport.
Sport we'd like, Paul. Excellent. £30 bonus you've got, Paul. Well done. And the question for another £30. What was the name of the 1983... 12-metre yacht which competed in the America's Cup for Britain?
Victory.
Victory what?
Victory 83.
That's £30, giving you a total of £60. So, Philip, choose a subject for Gary.
History.
History we'd like. Come on, Gary, and the best of luck. History we're looking for. It's not. It's affairs, but it's early days, so don't worry about that. There's no bonus, but for £30, Philip. In which county is Greenham Common, the site of the controversial women's peace camp?
Berkshire.
Good lad. £30 you've got. Well done. We move on and we look at Pauline to choose a subject for Terry.
Britain, please.
Britain we'd like, Terry. Britain we're looking at. Or Great Britain, as we should say now. Well done. £50 bonus you've got, Terry. Good lad. So for a further £50, Pauline, a Great Britain question, what do peers of the realm, lunatics and jailbirds have in common?
Asylum.
There's a light on, and I can pass it across. The time did go. She did give an answer. She said asylum. In fact, it wasn't. I know what she was thinking. Philip, can you tell me?
They're not allowed to vote in the general
Good election. Answer. Excellent answer. Gives you a further £30. Right, at the end of that round, we have Mal and Paul with £60, Gary and Philip with £60, and Terry and Pauline with £50. Still very even. As we move to round two, this time the questions are worth £50 each. Let's have a look at what we've got left. Food, places, showbiz, history, books, words and spelling. What do you think, Mal?
History.
History we'd like, Paul. It's there, £30 bonus again. Well done, Paul. For another £50, Mal, what was the name of the German airship which caught fire at the end of a flight across the Atlantic in 1937?
Hindenburg.
Hindenburg is right. Gives you another £50. Well done. And we move on. We move on to Philip to choose a subject for Gary.
Places.
Places we want. Come on, Gary. Places we're looking for. Well done, Gary. £50 you've got. Philip, for another £50. The bridge on the River Kwai that told the story of prisoners of war building a railway during World War II, in which country was it? And there's a light on.
Singapore?
It wasn't, and we can offer it across to Pauline.
Malaysia?
It wasn't. It was Burma. Never mind. We carry on, and it's Pauline to choose a subject for Terry.
Words, please.
Words we'd like. Come on, Terry. Words we'd like. It's there. It's just in. Well done. For another £50, you've got a £50 bonus, Terry. Pauline, for another £50. What is remarkable about the words facetious and abstemious? Think about the construction.
No idea.
You will kick yourself. There's a light on, Mal.
Same number of vowels?
Yes, we'll take it. In fact, they contain the five vowels only once. All the vowels are there. The secret was the vowels. So it's right, you've got a £50 bonus, Mal, which means at the end of round two, we've got Paul and Mal with £190, Gary and Philip with £110, and Terry and Pauline with £100. So it's all to play for as we move to round three in this part of the game. And here the questions, oh, it can all completely upend here because the questions are worth £100 each, as you know by now. More difficult questions and less categories for the boys to aim at. So let's look at what we've got left. We've got food, showbiz, books and spelling. What do you think, Mal?
Spelling.
Spelling we'd like, Paul. £50 bonus you've got. You're a good team, you really are. Mal, for £100, to violate a sacred building is to be sacrilegious. Spell sacrilegious.
S-A-C-R-I-L-I-G-O-U-S.
He's wrong, and I can offer it across. I can offer it to Philip.
S-A-C-R-I-L-I-G-I-O-U-S.
It's not. It is, in fact, S-A-C-R-I-L-E-G-I-O-U-S. So you all got your eyes and ears the wrong way around. Never mind. It was well worth having a go for. Philip, it's your turn. Choose a subject for Gary.
Showbiz, please.
Showbiz we'd like. Well done. £50 bonus you've got there. Well done, Gary. Philip, for £100. Clint Eastwood came to fame in the television series, in the television western series, Rawhide. What was the name of the character he played? And there's a light on. For £100.
I don't know.
You can offer it across to Mal.
Rowdy Yates.
Good answer. Well done, Rowdy Yates. What a, that was worth a round of applause. Well done. Ooh, marvellous. Pauline?
Food, please.
Food we want for Terry. It is survival time for this couple now. That's fine. That's a bonus for £50, which puts you £10 behind Philip and Gary. Pauline, listen to the question. What colour is the liqueur Chartreuse?
Green.
Green is right. For £100, which gives you £250, which means, sadly, at the end of that round, we've got to say cheerio to Gary and Philip, but the scores, Paul and Mal with £340, Pauline and Terry with £250, and sadly, Gary and Philip with £160, so we've got to say cheerio to you boys. In you come. Give them a nice round of applause.
You've done very well, lads, you really have. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six. £160. Not bad for a night's work, was it, boys? Have you enjoyed it?
Very much, sir.
We'd like you to take that money with our compliments. It's been lovely having you with us. There's the money. Oh, there we are, Gary. And the bullseye darts and, of course, the solid silver keyring. Privileged to have you on the show. There you are, Philip. Thank you very much indeed.
Nice.
Lovely audience. They're going to give you a nice round of applause because they've been grand lads. Give them a round of applause. Thank you very much.
Okay. Well done. Come and have a look at the board. You know this by now. It's the normal match play dartboard. You've probably got one at home in your garage. Here we ask the two remaining dart players to compete in three rounds of darts against each other. And the winner of each round wins for his partner a question. And the value of that question is the winning score. You know that by now, don't you? So, lads, it's pounds for points. Come on, Paul, up to the hockey. That's fine. Come and stand with me. Over to Tony.
And it's first round. It's Paul to throw. That's five. 20. Another 20, so that's 45 for Paul. Terry, 45 to beat. One. It's outside the board. Oh, another one, just two. So the first round to Paul.
So, Malcolm, this question is worth to you £45. You can now telephone many places in the world on STD. Can you tell me what the initials STD stand for? We can buzz you out, we can offer it to Pauline. It's only £2, Pauline, but what do you think?
Standard telephone direct?
It's not. In fact, I'm surprised you didn't know that, actually, because you're both well informed. It's subscriber trunk dialing. And you both knew it. Never mind. Gives us 340 players, 250. No score. Over to Tony for round two.
Round two, and it's Paul to start. It's treble 20. That's 60. Good start. That's another 20. And that's a one, so that's 81 for Paul. So, Terry, what to do? That's 20. It's out the board again. And that's a 5, so that's 25. Second round to Paul.
Malcolm, this is a very expensive question. It's worth £81 to you. In 1859, a bell was salvaged from the wreck of a British ship and it was hung in the insurance office of Lloyd's of London. It's named after the ship and is traditionally rung before announcements of shipping disasters. Can you tell me the bell's name?
No, Jim.
You can't tell me. Never mind, Mal. What about you, Pauline?
Liberty.
It's not. You got the first letter right. You will know it. It's the lutine. L-U-T-I-N-E. Oh, both of you knew it, didn't you? So still, we haven't scored anything in this round. We move on to Tony, to the third part of this section of the game.
And it's the final round. Round three. Paul throwing. It's 5. It's a 1. And that's a 20. So 26 for Paul. So a good chance for Terry. Been throwing bells out the board. It's 20. Well, that's double 5, that's 10. And that's another double 5, so that's 40 for Terry, but takes the final round.
Right. Pauline, this is your question for £40 to give you quite a respectable score at the end of the evening. Catgut is strong, translucent cord used for the strings of violins and tennis rackets. It does not, however, come from cats. Can you tell me one of the animals from which it is obtained?
Pigs.
Is wrong.
Goats.
Is wrong. In fact, it's sheep or horse. So you've had an incredibly successful round there. You've scored not a penny between you, which means at the end... No, don't be too depressed. You've still done. It's been well worth your while coming. £340 for Paul and Mal. Terry and Pauline, we've got to say bye-bye to them, but they're going home with £250. Give them a nice encouraging round of applause. Come on, Pauline. Come on, Terry. Well done. Well done, Terry. Good job, Pauline. Tell you what, you've been marvellous, have you? Really, have you enjoyed your day?
Thoroughly enjoyed it.
Well, it really has been a privilege having you. You've been a lot of fun. You've got the two bullseye tankards, which are engraved and are worth a lot of money, the bullseye darts and the solid silver keyring, and, of course, £250. Stay with us, because you know the chemistry of the game now. You could well be coming back, couldn't you? Maybe to win the star prize. We'd certainly like to see you, to see what happens anyway. Pop back in a couple of minutes. See you soon.
Who's behind the door? It's number 4.
If you or someone you know owned or leased a diesel vehicle between 2009 and 2020, you could be entitled to significant compensation. And at My Diesel Claim, we're experts in handling these claims. Millions of drivers have been misled by numerous manufacturers about emissions, and hundreds of thousands have already filed their claims. Simply visit our site now and check your vehicle instantly. It's completely free to sign up, and you can start your claim in seconds. Visit mydieselclaim.com and join thousands of others starting their claims today.
You can't play here!
Come on.
We rise by lifting each other. Kenko, made to uplift.
From the Arctic to the tropics and rivers to rainforests, get closer to islands bursting with life.
What have we learned about K-pop? We know that it's slick vocals, incredible choreography, presentation style. So in that way, mission achieved.
A new episode every Wednesday on Sky Max.
Now that's what I call lucky.
Well, I'm glad you stayed with us. It's great. We're having a lovely time tonight. Incredible audience this night. I hope you're enjoying it at home. We'd like you to welcome a gentleman from a long, long way away, from, in fact, almost the other side of the world, the Singapore darts champion. Let's have a nice Great Britain welcome for Paul Lim.
Hello, Paul. Welcome to the show.
First time on the show, and welcome to England, of course. You're over here, what, just to compete in a few other competitions?
Yes, I'll be.
Yes?
A few more competitions.
That's come. Fine. Are you because I know you did well in Australia, didn't you?
Yes, I did, yeah.
Was it... You won the...
I won the Canberra Open.
The Canberra, that's right, yeah, which is quite a big competition.
Oh, it is, actually.
That's
yeah.
Fine. Tell us a little bit about your private life. You've just got married, haven't you?
Yes, I have. I'm a British lady. My wife is just over there.
She's with you here, is she? Yes, that's fine. Well, that's excellent. Now, do you know what we'd like you to do on the competition? We'd like you to score 301 or more. If you can do that, we'll double it and give it to the charity chosen by the... by our finalists, you see. All right. They're all with you, the audience. Give him a nice round of applause. He's a lovely fellow. In you go, Paul. Let's go.
So here's Paul Lim, the first of his nine darts. Singapore champion. And that's 20. Another 20. And that's treble one. That's unlucky. That's 43. Another 20. And a treble 20. 100! So just three darts to go. 143 scored. 20. Another 20. Another 20, that's 60, so that's 203 for Paul.
Well done, Paul. Well done. Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. Nice to put forward it. It's not all that easy, is it? Because you've got to do it cold, haven't you? Now then, Malcolm and Paul, meet this young gentleman all the way from Singapore who has got for you £203 for charity, and I'm sure you're very grateful to him. Tell us about the charity, Mal.
Well, it's a local charity. It's the Moneyhall Hospital in King's Heath.
Yes, in Birmingham.
Birmingham. It's their 75th anniversary this year. Yeah. And unfortunately, their minibus has fallen apart and they'd like some money towards a new one.
Well, that will go nicely towards it, won't it? Courtesy of our friend from Singapore, I'm sure you'd like to thank him, as we all would, and our studio audience. Super fellow, wasn't he? Great. Threw well too, didn't he? Yeah. Just a whisker away from doing it for you. We're going to show you Bully's prize board now. You've seen it on the last two series. Did you ever think you'd come face to face to it?
No.
You didn't. How does it feel now you're going to do that?
It's a little easier now.
Come and have a look and I'll explain it to you. Come on, Paul, you come with me. I'm Malcolm. It's Bully's prize board, your chance to win some marvellous prizes. It's a test of memory as well as skill, of course, because we've got black segments and red segments, and in every red segment, some super prizes.
In one, for the year-round tan, a sunbed. In two, 10 bottles of French wine. In three, press ahead with this rotary iron. In four, a full and half sovereign gold rings. In five, a fridge with drinks dispenser. In six, a liquidizer that blends, dices, chops and grates. In seven, it's thrills and spills with this kiddie's scrambler bike. In eight, a portable radio recorder. And Bully's special prize this week, for shooting those magical moments, a VHS video camera.
What about that? Now then. All right. Did you remember those prizes and where they were?
I think so.
We hope you did. Now, a little rhyme just to help you with the game. Keep out of the black and in the red. You get nothing in this game for two in a bed. Nine prizes. You've got nine darts. Six for you, Paul. Three for you, Mal. OK. We wish you the best of luck. In you go, Paul, for your first three. Over to Tony.
So, darts for prizes. Paul to throw. First of the nine darts. That's red. It's number four.
And you've won the gold rings. Two gold rings. Excellent.
Red number five.
You've won the fridge.
That's in the black.
Oh, I thought you'd lost the fridge. Oh, you're all right.
So, Mark. First of his three darts. Black. That's red. It's number six.
That's fine. That's the Magimix.
Black.
Well, you're all right.
And with three darts to go, and it's Paul to throw. That's black. Black again. But that's red. It's number one.
And you've won the sunbed. So you've done very well. You've got four prizes. Let's have a look. You have won the sunbed, the two gold rings, the fridge, the Magimix, and, of course, Bully's game. We'd like... Yes, yes, good. Good. Now then, the money for charity's sake. We'd like you to consider a gamble. We'd like you to gamble the prizes you've won there against tonight's star prize, which is hiding behind Bully. And you know it's always a bit special, don't you? 101 or more with six darts, you know by now. Three for you, Paul. Three for you, Mal. You've got the time it takes that board to revolve to tell us what you'd like to do. I do work. You've decided definitely going... Are they right, do you think, boys and girls? Are they right to go for it? Yeah. You think so with four prizes? Well, we're all rooting for you. Everybody all over Great Britain who's watching the programme rooting for you. It's the non-dart player to go first, Mal. All right, we're all with you. Paul, come and stand with me. Up to the hockey, Mal, and it's over to Tony.
For tonight's star prize, 101 or more, six darts, Mal to start. That's four. That's a 20. And that's outside the board, so 24 scored for Mal, leaving 77 or more for Paul. That's five. So it can't be done, unlucky, but that's the gamble.
There you go, boys. Come and have a look at it. Have a look at what you would have won anyway. Come on, it's going up. Let's have a little peep at it. There you go. Never mind, stay where you are there. You've done all right. You're still not the end of the world. You've won £340. Turn around and face the audience. Let them see. Go in there, Paul. That's fine. The bullseye tankers, you've still got your money. You're all right. You've done very well. Use your darts and your silver key. Well, it's been nice having you on the show, boys. And you're allowed to go. You're all right. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks very much indeed for watching Bullseye. Thanks to Tony Green, to Paul Lynn, to our contestants, our studio audience and yourselves for watching it. Have a good week, because remember, the week wouldn't be the same without a bit of Bully. Bye!
'66. Give us a clickety-click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
What's your little piece of warmth?
For me, it's when I'm on tour with my favourite band.
During my cosiest movie nights in.
And for me, it's that moment to myself whilst out walking the dogs.
Werther's Original, your little piece of warmth.
Would you like one?
Mother, father, I need to tell you something.
You're moving out?
No. It's about my Mola Rice.
It's so much worse.
I want it warm.
Nonsense! The microwave is for soup or drying socks, not warming Mola Rice.
I want mine warm too.
Mola, love every bit.
It gives me great pleasure to welcome each and every one of you.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Expelliarmus!
Wicked.
What brings you here?
Same as you.
Come closer, brother wizards, join us.
I cannot move against Grindelwald. It has to be you.
picture every Wizarding World movie in one magical place.
Be glad you came. Trust me.
Sky Cinema Wizarding World. Available now.
He was called the Torso Killer.
My game with him was to get him to confess.
What did you do with the body?
Put it near a river.
I'm getting some static from polyester blouses, and I can smell the hairspray from here. It must be time to play Bullseye on Challenge.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecha Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
A cartoon bull wearing a red and white striped shirt, a toothy grin and clutching a set of darts leaps from a pub sign, surprises the white dog sat below and enters the traditional-looking timbered pub where a darts contest banner is draped above the door. He passes drinkers at the bar and goes over to the dartboard where he stands on the hockey and throws a dart into the red bullseye.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host for this evening, Mr. Jim Bowen.
Welcome to another Sunday evening with Bullseye. We've got some great people to play the game tonight. From all over the place, the first couple, all the way from Yorkshire Television, we're going to give them a nice welcome because we hope they do well. Ivor Patrick and Steve Bloy.
The two contestants stand in front of the Bullseye board.
And young Steve, nice to have you with us. From Yorkshire, where, you're from...
Grimsby.
From Grimsby, oh, yeah, well, that's really East Coast, isn't it? What do you do, Ivor?
I'm a police officer.
Police officer, that's fine. What did you do before you were a police officer?
I was on the milk rounds.
You're a milkman?
Milkman, yeah.
Oh, so you needed a lot of bottle for both, really, didn't you?
That's right, yeah.
Now, what about this... What's your hobby?
I enjoy playing golf.
You like golf?
Yeah.
Well, now, that's fast, because, I mean, I suppose with the police and milkman, the milk round and the police round and the golf, you'd be never off your feet, would you, really?
Not really, yeah.
Oh, have you any family?
Yes, I've got two young children.
So you've been off your feet a couple of months or twice. That's nice to have you with it. Two youngsters. Now then, Steve, what do you do?
I'm a sales manager.
And in what line of business do you
sell? For domestic laundry in East Lincolnshire.
Oh, yeah. So you ask them to come clean and you make sure they do?
That's right.
Yeah. That's very good, isn't it? It's going well, this. It's going well, isn't it, this? Is it Madame Tussauds out there? Are you with us? It's a privilege to have you both with us from the East Coast. Steve, have a little sit down and relax for a minute. And Ivor, we'll see you in a couple of seconds. And the next couple tonight, they're from Central Region, Dennis Beardmore and Eddie Baxter. Make them nice and welcome.
The next pair meet Jim by the podium.
That's good, Dennis. And Eddie, that's lovely to have you with us. What do you do, Dennis?
Oh, well, I'm a bank officer.
A bank officer?
Yeah.
And your hobbies?
Golf.
Golf? Yeah. So I suppose if we went on the golf course, we'd see a banker in a bunker.
That's about
What about you, Eddie? What do you do, young sir?
I've run marathons, play chess and squash.
Really? We get all the athletes on, don't we? You with the golf and the thing. That's right. And you're a league man?
Yes.
You're a league
That's
man?
That's right.
Well, you know your onions. Now, now you have a unique claim to fame, don't you, Eddie? Go on, tell
I got me. In the Guinness Book of Records.
Right, go on, tell us what for.
Eating prunes.
Hey, we can dig them up here, you know. Hey, go on, tell us.
Well, I ate 130 prunes in 116 seconds.
How's that? Hey, has anybody taken the record off here? Are you still on the throne?
No.
And here we get one. Hey, great lads. The mental bit, the grand lads. Go and have a little sit down, Eddie. Nice to have you with us, Dennis. Good lad, off you go. That's fine. And the third couple tonight, two lovely ladies from Harlech Television, Novella James and Hilary Richmond. Make them nice and welcome.
Enter the ladies.
Hello, everybody.
And Hilary. Well, you pair of lovely ladies. Nice to have you with us. Novella. What do your friends call you?
Vel.
Vel. Mm-hmm. What do you do for a living, Vel?
I'm a domestic in a local hospital.
Oh, yes. You're a cleaner, I suppose.
Cleaner, yes.
So you'll be one of the original Welsh Valleys. Laugh, I nearly passed my fags around. No. Hilary? Yes. What's your... we call you Hill?
Yes.
So we've got Vel and Hill. Yes. And what, have you a job?
No, housewife.
You're a housewife. That's a full-time job, isn't it? Yeah. And you were in a quiz, because you do the pub quizzes, don't you? You join in the quizzes. Tell us about this lovely prize you won once.
12 pints of Guinness.
Well, that's a lovely, that's a feminine prize, isn't it? 12 pints of Guinness. And what's your hobby?
My hobby?
Yeah.
Well, crosswords, walking with
and
the
you
dog.
Like walking? Yeah, yeah, well, that'll be handy with the 12 pints of Guinness. <they'd be all laughs> yes. We hope you give us a chance to show your talents tonight on the dartboard, because we do know you're a fair player. We've watched you all day. And Hilary, a chance for you to acquit yourself academically. Right. Go and have a little sit down there. And over you go, Valerie. Thank you very much indeed. That's right. OK. You know the score by now. We've met the contestants and they're all ready to play the game. We'll just go through it. You know about the board over there. We've done it a million times now, haven't we? It's Bully's prize. It's the category board, and the dart players get a chance to win questions for the partners. Here are all the questions waiting to be answered. We arranged the order of play before we came on the air tonight, and they're all sitting there ready to play the game. So, Steve, it's your question, and the questions in the first round are worth £30 each. All right? Steve, choose a subject for Ivor.
History, please.
History we'd like. Come on, Ivor.
Ivor steps up to the hockey.
That's a good start for your £50 you've got before you even answer a question. And here's your question for another £30, Steve. Who was nicknamed the Iron Duke?
The Duke of Wellington.
Good answer. Well done, Steve. Sure, you're in with £80. Before we go any further, Eddie, choose a subject for your partner, Dennis.
Sport, please.
Sport we'd like. Come on, young Dennis.
Dennis takes aim.
It's there. £50 again you've got. Well done, Dennis. Eddie, for another £30. In 1965, two brothers became the first in the 20th century to play together in an England team at full international level. We are speaking about soccer. Can you tell me who they were? And there's a light on. You're going to kick yourself, Eddie. Steve knows.
Bobby and Jackie Charlton.
Excellent answer. Well done. Another £30 you've got. So we move on. Hilary, choose a subject for Vella.
Britain, please.
Britain we'd like, Vella. Come on, my love. Britain we'd like. Excellent. Well done, Vella. £50 you've got, Hilary. For another 30, giving you 80 in all. In which town did the investiture... Listen to this for a couple of Welsh ladies. In which town did the investiture of Prince Charles as the Prince of Wales take place in 1969?
Carnarvon.
You dare get that wrong. Good girl, well done. At the end of that first round, we're all going very nicely. Ivor and Steve with £110, Dennis and Eddie with £50, Vella and Hilary with £80. Sure, they're going well, aren't they? Give them a round of applause. They're doing very well. All right. We move on to round two now. Here the questions are worth £50 each. They're a little bit more difficult, as you know by now, and less areas for the dart player to aim at. In fact, what we've got left are food, places, showbiz, affairs, books, words and spelling. What do you think, Steve?
Showbiz, please.
Showbiz you'd like. OK, Ivor. Showbiz you'd like. £30 you've got, Ivor. Well done. Steve, for a further £50, which cartoon and movie character was born on the planet Krypton and was sent to Earth as a baby?
Superman.
Superman. Good. That's very good. Well done. OK, we move on. Eddie, what do you think for a subject for Dennis?
Food, please.
Food we'd like, Dennis. Food we're looking at. That's fine. That's a £50 bonus you've got. So, Eddie, here's your question. Caviar is the roe of fish, and true caviar is the most expensive food in the world. From which fish is it obtained?
The sturgeon.
The sturgeon. Well done. That's fine. Abstained. That's very good. Excellent. Hilary, choose
words,
a subject
please.
For that. Sorry, sweet.
Words, please.
Words you'd like. Good girl, Vella. Well done, because the dart playing really is excellent tonight. Really is super. For another £50, Hilary, who is the primate of all England? You've been belled, and we can offer it across to Eddie.
Archbishop of Canterbury.
He's right. So at the end of that round, we've got Ivor and Steve with £190, Dennis and Eddie with £200, and Vella and Hilary with £130, so it's all to play for as we go to round three. Here, as you know by now, the question's worth £100 each. Little more difficult again, and considerably less areas for the dark players to throw at. What we've got left are places, affairs, books, and spelling. It's all on the last round. Steve, choose for Ivor.
Affairs, please.
Affairs we'd like. Well done, £50 again. The dart players really are doing well tonight. This is for £100 more, Steve. In 1983,
the first American woman astronaut rode into space on the space shuttle. What was her name?
Sally Ride.
What a very good answer. That's worth a round of applause. Well done. So, Eddie, choose a subject for Dennis.
Spelling, please.
Spelling we'd like. Come on, Dennis. Spelling we want. It's there again. £50 you've got. Marvellous. For another £100, Eddie, when coconut is dried, it's desiccated. Please spell for me the verb desiccate.
D-E-S-S-I-C-A-T-E.
Is wrong, and we can offer it across. Steve?
D-E-S-S-I-C-A-T-E.
Is wrong. It's D-E-S-S-I-C-C-A-T-E. Never mind, so near and yet so far. Don't worry about it, you're still going all right. Now then, Hiller, it's survival time. What do you think for Vella?
Places, please.
Places we'd like. Come on, Vella. Places we'd like. Good girl, Vella. £30 you've got. The largest island in the Mediterranean has a population of around 5 million. Which is it?
Don't know. Sorry.
You really are going to kick yourself. Steve?
Sicily.
Sicily's right. Did you know it, Hilary?
Yes,
never mind. Gives us the scores. They're good scoring rounds tonight because the dart players have done so very well. Ivor and Steve with £440. Dennis and Eddie with £250. And sadly, the two girls from Wales, we've got to say cheerio to them, but they're taking £160 with them. Give them a nice round of applause. Come on, girls. That was... I think that was as good a dart playing as we've had. I think all the dart players got every subject, didn't they? So you really did very, very well. You didn't let yourselves down. Competition a bit fierce tonight. There are the bullseye darts and the solid silver keyring and £160. There's the money. Put that away. Save up for some bits and bats there. There you are. Oh, you, that's fine. You take the dart. Shake
Thank
hands
you.
Before you go. Vella and Hilary, nice to have you with us. Give them a nice round of applause. Well done. Two smashing ladies, really. We've had a lot of fun with them. They were great. Come and have a look at the board. Match play board again, as you know. The sort of thing you've got at home. In this part of the game, we ask the two remaining dart players to compete in three rounds of darts against each other. The winner of each round wins for his partner a question. And the value of that question is the winning score. So, lads, it's pounds for points. Ivor, up to the hockey. Come on, Dennis, come and stand with me. It's over to Tony Green for part two of the game.
First round, Ivor to throw. And that's treble 12, which is 36. That's a one. And that's another one, so that's just 38 scored for Ivor. Dennis then, 38 to beat. 20. That's a five. Another 20, so that's 45. First round to Dennis.
So it's a question for Eddie, and it's worth £45 to you, Eddie, is this? What is the temperature of a healthy human body in Fahrenheit? Degrees Fahrenheit.
97.4.
The buzzer had gone and it was wrong, so we can offer it across. Can you give it me, Steve, for £38?
98.6.
It's wrong. In fact, we wanted it exactly because it's a fairly well-known. It's 98.4. So you both got one figure right, but never mind. No scores as we move on to round two, and it's back to Tony.
And it's Ivor to start round two. It's 20. It's a five. And that's a treble five. So that's 40 for Ivor. And Dennis already on his mark with 40 to beat. That's five. That's a treble one, three. Oh, and that's a bounce out, just eight. So the second round to Ivor.
So it's Steve, it's worth £40 to you this, Steve. The first ever astronaut to be launched into space died in 1968 in an air crash. What was his name?
Yuri Gagarin.
That's excellent. £480, place 250, and we go on to round three, and over to Tony again.
And this the final round. It's Ivor to throw. It's 20. Another 20. And another 20, so that's 60 for Ivor. So Dennis, 60 to beat. Good start. Double top, 40. There's a five. Oh, and that's a one. No, I'm sorry, that's a 20, so it is 65. So the final round goes to Dennis.
Well done, excellent. So this, it's worth £65 to you, Eddie, is this? Listen very carefully to this question now, Eddie. The Trans-Siberian Railway is 5,000...